Hello everybody, I'm Abhyuday and today we are going to discuss the Mahabharat. So our story starts long ago at the kingdom of Hastinapur, which is now Delhi. The kingdom of Hastinapur was ruled by the Kuru dynasty. The king of the Kuru dynasty was Dushyant. And Dushyant was a brave king. And plus, he started the Kuru dynasty. He married Shakuntala and together they had one son whose name was Bharat. Bharat also had sons. But when he was dying, he thought to himself, these sons cannot take over the throne. They don't have knowledge about ruling a kingdom. So one day he organized an event that all the men of his kingdom could come and they could participate in a challenge. They could participate in a challenge. And that challenge included knowledge and, weapons. Meaning, how did they use the weapons? Knowledge and weapons. So, whoever would succeed in this test would become the next king. And out of all of them, there was one boy named Shantanu. And he succeeded. And he became the adopted son of Bharat. Shantanu became king. He married two times. His first wife was Ganga. Ganga had a son whose name was Devaratra. People call him Bhishma today. Then he also married Satyavati, who before married Shantanu, she married sage Prasar and gave birth to sage Vyas. And then on her second marriage, she gave birth to two kids whose name were Chitrangra and Vichitravir. Bhishma had promised that he would not take over the throne. And he would never marry and would not have children. So Chitranga was made king. But Chitranga died in a battle and Vichitravir was made king. One day, Satyavati, the stepmother of Bhishma, asked him to find brides for Vichitravir. He went to the king of Kashi's palace, who was holding a Swayamvar for his three daughters, Amba, Ambalika, Ambika. Now, what is Swayamvar? Swayamvar is a ritual where a girl's father organizes the girl's wedding and men from all over would come to marry the girl. And there are two types of Swayamvars. One of them is like, there would be a certain challenge or competition. Whoever wins will become the husband. The other one is that the girl just has to choose. That's it. The king of Kashi was holding the choosing Swayamvar. So when Bhishma came, everybody joked that an old man had come to marry young princesses. Angry Bhishma, who was also known for his anger, strike two arrows at the princess, and all of their crowns broke into pieces. When all of their crowns broke, all of the princes felt scared and they like ran away to save their life. Amba, Ambalika, and Ambika were taken to Hastinapur by force. Amba said she wanted to marry Prince Shavla. So she was sent to Prince Shavla. While Ambalika and Ambika were married to Vichitravir. One day they went to meet Sage Vyas with their maid. So Sage Vyas was actually very ugly at that time. So when Ambalika saw him, she closed her eyes, and Sage Vyas cursed her that she would have a blind son. Ambika, when she saw him, turned pale. And when she turned pale, Sage Vyas said that she would give birth to a weak son. So the first son was Dhritarashtra. And then Ambika's son was Pandu. Now, the maid son was Vidur, who was an intelligent guy. So he was made a minister in the court. Pandu married Kunti and Madri, while Dhritarashtra married Gandhari. Kunti, before marriage, had married someone else, whose name was married someone else, and she had another son whose name was Karan. Karan was actually a Pandav. Karan was actually a Pandav, but he joined the Kaurava side because Duryodhan had made him a king. So Kunti gave birth to Yudhishthir, Bhim, and Arjun, while Madri gave birth to Nakul and Sahadev, who were twins. Dhritarashtra married Gandhari, as you know, and they gave birth to 101 children. 100 of them were 100 of them were boys, and one of them was a girl. The eldest was Duryodhan, the second one was Dushyant, and the youngest, who was a daughter, was Dushla. And 98 more, and I mean 97 more followed. Dhritarashtra had married a maid before. Before he married Gandhari, he had married a maid servant, and they gave birth to a boy whose name was Yutsuv, who later joined the Pandavas in the war. As you know, Gandhari gave birth to 101 children. So one day, Pandu was going out hunting, and he heard something. Thinking to be an animal, he shot the arrow in the way, and when he came to the spot, he saw a saint lying dead. Soon other saints came, and they were so furious that they cursed Pandu to death. But Pandu said that he would live in the forest to overcome the curse. So they said okay, they changed the curse that he would have to live in the forest for his life. Kunti Madri accompanied Pandu to the forest. Over there, they gave birth to five children. One Pandu's health became sicker and sicker and sicker every day. Until one day, Kunti and the five kids went out to collect some wood. Pandu was like, and he then later died. Madri could not bear to see this, and she also died. Now Kunti saw this, and she saw that all the five would be now raised by her and nobody else. So she went to Hastinapur, where everybody greeted her with a warm welcome. And soon they were sent to go to Gurukul, and the Gurukul teacher was Bhishma. But later, after some incident, the royal teacher was declared what was it? Yeah, Dronacharya. His name was Dronacharya. So after the completion and studies, Duryodhan felt that he should be the next king because his father was at the throne. So he decided to kill his cousins. He invited them to a festival in where he had built a lace palace. Lace burns very easily. So he said that they could sleep over here for the night. Vidur came to know about this and told the Pandavas about this. He said he was having a secret tunnel built for them. And he also said that there were 5 boys and 1 girl servant. So when those servants die, Duryodhan would think that the Pandavas would have died. And Krishna, a friend of Arjun since a very young age, had organized a boat in the side of the river with the hole ended. So at night, when all of the 5 were sleeping, Bhim himself set the lace palace on fire. The lace palace started burning and the Pandavas escaped. The servants died, so Duryodhan thought that, these guys are dead. But actually, they went over to another village and spent their days in hiding. This also happened an incident when the demon Hidim attacked them and Bhim defeated Hidim. Hidimba, Hidim's sister, married Bhim. And they had a son. So they went back to Hastinapur. Krishna sent Akhur to Hastinapur to calm down the difficulties. Akhur said, Dronacharya, King Dhritarashtra, Queen Gandhari, and all the members of the royal family, you want to give the Hastinapur to the Pandavas, but the Pandavas are not sure if they are safe near Duryodhan. Krishna advised Akur to divide Hastinapur between the Kauravas and the Pandavas to maintain peace. And soon 2 kingdoms were formed. The Pandavas happily accepted their kingdom, and with its capital as Indraprastha, they started ruling the country. They had a beautiful city been built by the architect Maya, who was also the king of giants. He built the illusion in the city. Even the gods came to see the city. So one day, Duryodhan felt that he should have that city. So he asked Yudhishthir to come and gamble with him. So he asked his uncle Shakuni, who was very wicked and he could gamble very well, to gamble in the name of him. So Shakuni said, okay. And Yudhishthir lost. He lost himself, he lost his army, he lost his family, he lost his kingdom, he lost everything that he had. And soon he became a slave of Duryodhan. Before that, all the 5 had married they had married Draupadi, princess of the king of Draupa kingdom. So when Draupadi was married, she also became lost. And then Duryodhan asked his brother to get Draupadi here. Karan said that they should strip Draupadi's clothes off. So when they were doing so, Krishna made Draupadi's clothes longer and longer and longer and longer. Everybody could not understand this. So then Dhritarashtra was seeing this. He felt sorry and gave back the kingdom back, everything that they had. Now Duryodhan was angry and said, "Father, you have spoilt our riches of our kingdom. Now see, they will attack us and kill us for revenge." He asked another game of gambling in which he won, and he sent them for 12 years of exile in a condition that in the 12th year of exile, they have to go on the hiding. And if they were found in the hiding, they would have to repeat their 12-year exile again. Now that is very worst. So they went for 12 years, and on the 13th year, they were like, "Where should we go for hiding?" And then they were suggested the king of Virata's palace. King Virat was a brave king, but now he was still how should I say this? He was still old. He was old. So all the power went in his son's hands. So they went to find jobs. Yudhishthira became an advisor. Bhim became a cook. Arjun, who had learned music, became the royal music teacher. And Nakul and Shahdev got also jobs. Draupadi got a job as a maid servant, meaning that she would become a maid of the queen. She had agreed on it in three conditions. Condition number one, she would not wash dirty utensils. Condition number two, she would not eat leftovers. Condition number three, she would not clean anybody's feet. So one day, the general who I mean was the son of Virat, meaning he had all the power in his hands. He asked Draupadi to marry him. Draupadi said that he should not trouble her. That prince was so angry at the boldness of that maid that he took her to the royal court, and he started beating her. So cryingly, Draupadi asked Bhim to kill the prince. So Bhim went and killed the prince. Now Duryodhan heard this and he thought that Bhim only was able to kill it. So he attacked Virat's palace. The general of Viratnagar, which was the kingdom which King Virat ruled over, was dead. So now who would defend? Now the 13th year of exile was over. So all the five brothers gave their identities away. So they helped King Virat to destroy the Kaurava army. So when they destroyed the Kaurava army completely, Duryodhan also came to know that they had found the Pandavas. He was happy that they had to repeat their 13-year exile again. But Bhishma warned him that the 13th year was already over. So there was no reason they had to come back. Now when they came back, the Pandavas demanded their kingdom back. But Duryodhan was like, "No." Then they sent Krishna. He said, "Give the back the Pandavas' share." Duryodhan was like, "No." And so Krishna said, "Okay, forget the half of the kingdom. They would be happy if they even got five villages." And Duryodhan was like, no, I will not even give a needle of my land. Let them fight if they want to. And Krishna was like, And then he went back to the Pandavas and said, war is coming. When he said, and so they both the sides prepared for war. So they had fixed 6 codes of war. Code number 1. It was that you don't harm anybody who is unequipped, meaning they don't have any. Number 2, do not harm a soldier who is already surrendered. Number 3, you should not no war at night. It would be deposed at sunset. Number 4, the war would be fair. Number 5. The camps where wounded officers would be kept would not be attacked. Number six. That was number 6 was that the soldiers carrying war equipped would not be harmed. So Bhishma, Drona, Dronacharya, Karana, and Duryodhan discussed their plans with the in the Kaurava side. While in the Pandava side, Krishna who had given his army all to Duryodhan, King Virat, few other kings. Yudhishthir, Arjun, and Bhim discussed their war plans. All the kings who wanted to help the Pandavas were there. So the war began, and at the first day of the war proved a disaster for the Pandavas. The 2 princes of Viratnagar had been killed by the Kaurava soldiers after killing hundreds of Kaurava soldiers. The second day was brilliant, and they won the day. Soon days passed by, and each day proving as a disaster. And on the 9th day of the battle, The Kaurava commander of army, Bhishma, had fallen. Arjun fired numberless arrows on him, every inch of his body. And like a bed of arrows, Bhishma was hanging upside down. Now, Bhishma had a boon that he could die whenever he wanted. Bhishma said that he will die only when his family was safe. Now none of his family was safe. All of them were fighting, so he had to stay like that until the end of the war. He said he was thirsty to Arjun. So Arjun shot an arrow and water came out. Bhishma drank the water and he called Duryodhan. He said that if they did not surrender and give back the half of the kingdom, then the Pandavas was surely evil. But Duryodhan was like, no, again. Bhishma even gave his bow to Abhimanyu, who had lost his bow. On the 10th, so everybody said they should make Karan, the new chief of commander. But Karan was like, no, you should make... who was that? Dronacharya, the commander. And everybody was like, yes, yes, you should make Dronacharya the commander. Karan had took a vow that he would not fight under Dronacharya. So he was about to leave. But when Dronacharya said for his friend Duryodhan, please fight, then he was like, okay. And everybody was very happy. So the war continued. And on the 13th day, Abhimanyu was killed. On the 14th day, Duryodhan's younger brother, whose name was Dushasan, was killed. At the time of Dushasan was also killed, Dronacharya was also killed. Now Karan became the next commander. And within the 15th day, only one day of his commandership, he was also killed. Then on the 16th day, Shaydev killed Shakuni. And soon on the 18th day, the war ended. And on the 17th day previously, whose name was that? Yeah. Draupadi's son, five sons were killed. The 17th day. And also Duryodhan was on his deathbed on the 17th day. Soon on the morning of the 18th day, the son of Dronacharya surrendered to the Pandavas and was taken as prisoner of war. And on the 18th day, the war ended with Pandavas' victory. And the Pandavas became king of Hastinapur. And within like that, Yudhishthir had gave up his kingship, and Yudhishthir and Arjun's son, who's Abhimanyu's son, Abhimanyu was not alive, so his son was made king. And today the kingdom of Hastinapur is right now Delhi, and it still lives. So everybody, hope you enjoyed. Bye bye. Did everybody like the show? Thumbs up or thumbs down? You can do the reactions like this. You can do it. Okay, bye bye everybody.
Bye bye. Bye bye.